I am so excited about today's road trip. We're heading up to Madison, Ohio, and you get two for the price of one. We're going to Debonair Winery, and right on premises is Cellar Rats Brewery. My dear beverage consultant, Phil Rita, turned me on to this. Phil, what is this place like?
Yo, dog, you know I love road trips, right? This place is one of only two places in the whole country that actually makes wine and beer on the same premises, and the folks are so nice up here. It's a beautiful setting. We're in for a really fun day today, dog!
What a great idea! So the beer lovers, they have their needs, and the wine lovers, Debonair's there for them. Let's go! This is gonna be so fun! Debonair Vineyards and Cellar Rats Brewery. It is a huge complex right here in Madison. Joel Sandry is the director of marketing, and you're gonna give us the 50 cent tour?
It's maybe even the 75 cent tour. We'll throw in a couple extra locations and, you know, bump it up a quarter.
There are expansions and brew tanks and of course lots of wine. So let's get started on our big tour. The DeBevick family is now in its third generation as winemakers and owners of Debonair Vineyards. They tend more than 170 acres of vines and produce more than 85,000 gallons of wine each year. They have expanded operations and now brew beer on premises. Cellar Rats Brewery produces a variety of quality craft beers. So now it's one-stop sipping when you visit Debonair.
This is where we do some of our aging for our Pinot Gris, Chardonnays, Cabernet Franc, Cab Sauv. We also have another red fermentation area or another barrel room where we do both stainless steel aging and barrel aging. When most people think about a wine cellar, this next room is exactly what they picture in their mind.
Oh,
whether
yeah.
they're in California or France or Germany yeah. or Australia or New Zealand, this next room is what they think of when they think wine.
How old is Debonair?
We've been operating as a winery since 1971. So next month we are having our 40th anniversary.
Nice, nice, that's exciting.
This is beautiful.
This is what people think about. When they think about a barrel aging room or where we have Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc being aged here that'll be blended into part of the wine that's being made in the stainless tanks. We've got a large combination of different things here in the wine being stored.
And this is the original aging room.
We are under the oldest part of the winery right now.
This is our Solera tank. We filled this up with our best reds. And every year we're going to empty it and bottle 1/3 of the wine in it and then replace it with 1/3 of this year's best reds. You want the winemaker to talk about this?
That might be good, actually. Yeah, maybe.
Perfect. Yeah. The winemaker.
Ed Trebitz is the winemaker here at Debonair Vineyards. And this is a very special barrel, the Solera?
Yes, this is a blend of Cabernet Franc, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Merlot from our vineyards in the Grand River Valley. Last year and the year before, we had a great growing season. So the grapes were able to ripen to where we needed them as far as sugar and the color intensity and flavor profile. So we decided, why don't we put this into a special cask, which these are called, and we'll sell it at a higher price and make it our specialty wine.
How has it tasted every year? Have you been happy with the results?
It's phenomenal. You want to taste?
Of course I do.
No, no.
Yeah, no, please, no, break my arm.
So this is kind of like the cuvee, am I right? It's like you're blending all the vintages in. Very exciting. Yeah.
So what we'll do is we'll take about 1/3 out, bottle it, and then put 1/3 back in. So every year you keep adding 1/3, taking 1/3 out. They do this in Greece with a wine called Labyrinth, where every year they'll just take a portion out and then put a new portion in and just keep doing that over and over through the years.
For the entire Debonair Vineyards, what is your production each year?
We do about 36,000 cases.
Wow.
But then if you include the other two wineries that I make wine for, we're looking at over probably 60,000, which accounts to about 150,000 gallons of wine.
Wow. That's a lot of
wine. And what is one of your favorite grapes to work with?
Cabernet Franc and Riesling. They have been very successful in competition.
And are they pretty consistent when you work with them for our area?
Well, the Riesling is Cabernet Franc, you need a good season. Last year was real wet, so we didn't get the ripeness that we needed.
How often do you taste this and do your quality control in this barrel?
Once a week.
Is this the first time you've had it this week?
Yes.
So let's see what the progress is. What do you think, Ed?
All right, here's Ed.
It's ready to be bottled, which it will be in the next couple.
This is really nice.
We'll be right back with craft beers from Cellar Rats Brewery. Debonair Vineyard's latest addition is Cellar Rats Brewery. Our tour continues with the brewing and bottling and, of course, a taste.
This is a testament that when a brewery makes good beer, they grow and they put in bigger systems.
Rat Tail Ale is our lead beer to market. Rat Tail Ale is being finished in this tank right now. It's got its last day in the fermentation tank, then it'll be transferred to the bright tank. It'll settle in the bright tank and be carbonated. From there, we will bottle. Basically, it looks like about 180 gallons will be bottled, and then the rest will be put in kegs for our distributor to take to market.
So this is your bottler right here.
This is our Mahin manual bottling line. It's a 6-head filling Mahin. So basically what happens is on a brew day, we've got our pre-trade up cases of beer that are already labeled. This beer is coming out nice and ice cold from the bright tank. So we can't put a label on a beer that's ice cold because the glass is all kind of misty. So we have to pre-label our beers. That was done a couple of days ago. A case is picked up at a time with a grabber, cleaned and rinsed out. You drop the entire case on, it slides down and fills 6 beers at a time. It then moves forward, it gets crowned 6 beers at a time, and then it pulls forward. We got a couple of guys here who grab those finished beers, put them in our six packs to cases to pallets to the distributor.
Tony DeBevick Jr. is working with Phil on his own private label beer. Tony, I think this is an awesome idea. These are bourbon barrels.
Yes, they are straight from Kentucky. We got those in last week. So when Phil was here before, when we brewed the beer, we had to go through the fermentation and the stainless. Once fermentation was complete, that's when we in turn came into the oak barrels.
Phil, tell me about this beer and your vision. I mean, I know you really know your beers. What were you looking for?
Very excited about this beer. Well, we wanted to make a Kentucky bourbon barrel ale, and Tony has been awesome to work with. We had so much fun brewing this beer. I drove to Salem, Ohio, to this little house called Misty's Maple Sugar House and bought 100% pure maple syrup and brought it up here, and Tony and I used that to make the beer. We put some really good grains in here, of course, hops. We put some vanilla bean
we took actual raw, fresh vanilla bean instead of doing an extract, and I actually cut them down the center and scraped the actual beans out.
Yes.
Those went in the barrel, and then we racked on top of them. So we wanted, when me and Phil first got together, our idea was this Kentucky bourbon barrel ale, but we wanted to do something different. We didn't want to follow kind of where the crowds are going. We wanted to do something that's special to us, special to Cellar Rats, special to Phil, you know, something that would be different than what everyone else is doing. So there's gonna be a little different characters in this, but that's why it's the Bitchin' Bourbon Barrel Ale.
And today we officially came up with the name. We decided officially, because while we were making this beer, we had some challenges along the way, but you know, it developed its own personality while we were brewing it. So yeah, Bitchin' Bourbon Barrel Ale, this will be the official beer of Big Tappin'.
Now, how long does this need to be in these barrels before we can try them?
Big Tappin'.
This is going to sit, just because we're so pressed for time, we might, probably the week before Big Tappin', we'll take a sample of it. 2 days before Big Tappin', it'll go into the cooler, it'll be carbonated, and it's going right before the Big Tappin', it's going down to Phil to be served.
Cool!
This is our Rat Tail Ale, our American Amber Ale.
Oh, the American.
This is our lead beer. This is the beer that went to market first. This is our traditional, delicious American Amber. And a nice American Amber Ale, I want it to start off nice and malty. I want it to be rich throughout, and I want it to finish up just a little caramely sweet on the end.
your average IPA is not going to have this type of color to it. It's going to be much more of a pale, real pale
yes.
straw kind of color. We've added a mid-palatal malt that's bright and rich. So what's going to happen is you start off real bitter, all of a sudden you go to soft and mild for just a second, and then right back to bitter.
That's our brand new POC. This will be coming out this May in stores. It's available on draft now, but this will be hitting stores this May. It was always called Pilsner on Call, but eventually started being named by the people of the area, the Pride of Cleveland. It was made throughout the really pre-prohibition, then after prohibition, all the way really into the 50s.
I remember
that. It disappeared
for
a while, and then it came back in the 70s with a brand new recipe that nobody liked. Mm. Nobody liked the Pride of Cleveland of the 70s. Then it's kind of disappeared, and now it's kind of nostalgic. We went out and decided that when we wanted to release our Pilsner, we wanted our special Pilsner to have a special name, and POC is what I went after. I was able to get the trademark and get the rights to it, and now we are ready to go, and we release this May. The Pride of Cleveland Pilsner. Bright, crisp, soft, drink these all day long, very, very sessionable, and we want to bring people to an exciting era of Pilsner drinking.
This is a true session beer, 4.5%.
Correct.
Can you tell he has the passion for what he
you
does?
You are so passionate.
I'm a big fan of what I do. I love beer. I'm a craft beer dork through and through. I love craft beer, and I'm passionate about what we're doing here. I know that we're producing great beer.
What was the impetus to start this brewery, to expand Debonair Vineyards?
It really came down to customer demand. They wanted something else. And this is how the whole thing came about, is trying to give them something else. Junior knows what he's doing as far as beer making. He's making great beers. I came on board to be the sales and marketing director for the winery, identified this as an opportunity because the beers were great. So we just started taking it out into the market. Everyone got excited about it. And what it comes down to is, if you try us, we'll infest you. I guarantee it.